हेलो एवरीवन, माय सेल्फ जया अग्रवाल, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर पॉलिटिकल साइंस फ्रॉम SPCGC अजमेर. दिस इज़ BA पार्ट थर्ड एंड इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू कवर द पेपर रिप्रेजेंटेटिव वेस्टर्न पॉलिटिकल थिंकर्स एंड टुडेज टॉपिक इज थॉमस हॉब्स. एंड when we start talking about Thomas Hobbes, then first of all which thing we prefer, that is about Thomas Hobbes, that was that he removed all restrictions or limitations which used to be imposed on sovereignty. In fact here comes the name, that is Boren, and he also considered sovereignty such which has no foundations of law, but at least we can see that natural law and constitutional law etc. were there, which worked as a restriction or limitation for sovereignty. But for Thomas Hobbes, there shouldn't be any restriction or limitation when we talk about sovereignty, as sovereignty is absolute for Thomas Hobbes, and sovereignty is the source of all rights, freedoms and all laws according to Thomas Hobbes. Second, his most prominent idea that comes for which Thomas Hobbes is known for, that is his social contract theory. And when we talk about his social contract theory, then we should keep it in our mind the thing which I have told you earlier, that is his ideas about sovereignty. So let's understand his social contract theory. So first, here comes the human nature. According to the Hobbes, that was he considered human nature as the human is selfish, timid, brutal, and he has desire for power, and all these things indicates that human nature is such kind of that there is always such kind of condition of war and struggle, and that is struggle for power. And second one is the state of nature, as the human nature is so, and so the state of nature, and this state of nature is always is a state that is always of struggle and war or fight. And we can see here that this the state of nature is based on might is right, and here everyone's life was miserable and there was no progress. We cannot even think of progress of a person in such kind of state of nature. And according to him, there were three reasons behind this struggle in this state of nature. First one was competition, second one was fear, and third one was glory. So here we can assume that why was there was need of a contract, and why people here were compelled or even thought about to leave this state of nature and or establish a new organization, because there was need of protection, peace and security. So the people here in the state of nature decided to leave this such situation and to establish a new institution, and all persons here surrender their or devote their whole powers to only one person or group of people. And the most important thing here is that this contract is mutual by public itself. Means this contract happened among the public itself, and the ruler or the sovereign is not a part of this contract. Therefore, the conditions of this contract cannot be we cannot say that sovereign is bound to follow this contract, as he is not a part of this contract. So that's all for today from my side. Thank you very much.